Hey, what's up, guys? It's time for another Pokémon Stadium Let's Play. In the last episode, we beat Misty, and the episode before that, we got through introductions and how the game works and what's in the game and all that sort of stuff, introductory stuff, first Let's Play, blah, 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 when we beat Brock. Now we're going to face off against Lieutenant Surge. Quite an interesting lineup. Anyway, like I said, I haven't gotten around to creating a master team in Pokemon Red yet, so for now we're just going to use all rental Pokemon. As you all may know, Lieutenant Surge is an expert in electric Pokemon, so the key here is ground Pokemon. Alright, Sandslash, Nidoking, whatever. It shouldn't be that hard anyway. Alright. Sort of diverse as well. Alright. You have 5 Pokemon that are weak against electric types, but we don't have an electric type, do we? So I probably should have picked up an electric type, but it's too late to back out now. So on the plus side, we do have we have 4 different Pokemon here that are weak against grass type Pokemon. Luckily, I do have some grass type Pokemon, and both of them have Mega Drain. Oh boy, why didn't I grab Weavin' Bell when I had the chance? This is going to be kind of a long fight, to be honest. Well, then again, it is Slowpoke, Shellder, and Krabby that, you know, should be easy to take out. Golduck, I'm not entirely sure about. I'm only saying that because Golduck is like an evolved form of Psyduck. Why is Golduck even called Golduck in the first place? He's not even gold. They should just switch places. Fun fact, I do have a Golduck that's in my Pokemon Blue cartridge. You know what I named it? Yeah, I just guess. If you guess Donald Duck, yes, you were right. Only I just named him Donald. Anyway, let's go with Executor. Alakazam, and let's see. I guess Parasect. Yeah, let's do that.
Here comes the first opponent. An easy victory should be within reach.
Even the game tells you. Really? Cool. Come here, you little crab.
Whoa!
Mega Drain! Yeah, I knew it. So, I don't know. I always like to be cautious about, these type of matches. Because you never know. There could be some surprises around the corner. Like Golduck, for example. I didn't know he was going to actually... Whatever. Let's try to take him out in one hit.
What
that? Ow! That hurt. Mega Drain.
Wow. No,
okay, not too bad. And how did I not fill up an HP with that one? Oh, whatever, I don't care. Ah, you keep getting criticals. Suck the life.
Wow,
I'm gonna suck your soul.
Is it down and out?
He looks like he just had a heart attack.
There's a difference.
He's like,
in the third Pokemon.
just like fell on the ground.
Oh, it's Slowpoke. The remaining Pokemon count is...
I love how the battle animation for Slowpoke is just him like standing there. Yeah, I knew this was gonna be.
What's this?
Ow!
What a furious battle!
Oh, by the way, in the main games, Payday is basically a move that lets you do, like, sort of decent damage, but also lets you get some extra money in the process. But in here, it has no point whatsoever. Oh, sorry for that. I had something in my throat. Something was like resurfacing. But yeah, the coins? They don't even show you the coins. So they do nothing. It's not like you can buy anything in the game, so... yeah. Sorry, I'm just like... trying to get something out of my throat. Something feels like it's stuck in there. Ugh. I don't like this feeling. It's like gross. Anyway, what are we looking at here? Voltorb, Electrode, Pikachu, Electabuzz. All these are good. All these are weak against ground types. Luckily, we have Marowak, and then also we have Porygon. Sandslash and Nidoking.
Here's the second adversary. The challenger needs to stay calm to earn victory.
I want my son back. Better give him back my son. Get out. Get out.
Now.
My soul will not rest until you give me back my son.
Here's the first move.
Lavender Town reference.
There, it's a hit.
Lavender Town is sort of creepy. I don't know. I wasn't really scared by it that much as some other people were.
No. Pokemon
looks wrong. I just one hit.
Down on
oh, another fun fact. If you have Pokemon Yellow, your Pokemon has, like, the anime voice actress doing the voice for Pikachu, and also has, like, these cool animations here. And if you teach your Pikachu Surf, it literally gets on a surfboard and starts surfing. So that's always fun. But I never taught my Pikachu Surf. What? Fire Blast only did that much?
What's this? Real bad.
I am... wow.
Neither one is...
I am, like, genuinely surprised here. What?
Savage attack. Harsh blow.
Harsh blow. Oh yeah, that did more damage than Fire Blast, the most powerful fire-type move. Of course, you're gonna take me out right here.
Good hit. Oh, is it down and out?
Use it as a cane.
Which Pokemon is coming
let's see.
Out?
I have to go Nidoking.
They strike fighting poses. Oh, it's Nidoking!
Oh yeah, we were speaking about, like, I forgot what part it was, but I remember, like, we were talking about, how Pokemon are sort of to scale in this game. Nidoking is, like, I believe, he didn't die there, poo-poo. Oh no, oh, I forgot, no, oh, luckily it didn't kill me.
The heat of battle rages.
That would be bad. Anyway, we were talking about how Pokemon were like to scale. Guess what Nidoking's height is? Aw, oh, just die already. Aw, oh, Jesus. I hope he doesn't get critical. Oh, dead! No! No! Nidoking. I'm sorry.
There's only one Pokemon left in reserve.
I might have fucked up here. Anyway, I was talking about like how Pokemon are to scale, and you know what Nidoking is like height is?
Pokemon against two now. A tense battle continues.
Nidoking is like, I believe he's like 4 foot or something like that.
Yeah,
like he's almost like the height of a kid almost. Which is total BS, because Neo King is such a badass Pokemon. I mean, he's cool in design, and he looks like he's a friggin' monster of a Pokemon. But no, apparently he's like no taller than a normal kid. That totally blows. Ugh. And so is Charizard, for that matter. Like, if you scale Charizard to, like, a full-grown adult, yeah, apparently you're, like, a bit taller than Charizard. It looks like you can, like, if you, like, okay, I'm about 6 foot, and he's, Charizard is about, like, 5 foot, two, I think it is? I have to check Bulbapedia for that. He basically is, like, you know, it's like a Pokemon that you would probably chill out with on the couch, really. Which totally blows, because I just want to ride Charizard in the battle. That totally blows. That was sort of a tough match, even though I totally BS'd it with Nidoking just using Poison Sting. That Porygon, though, it totally could dish out a lot of damage more than I thought it could. Alright, a lot of Pokemon here are weak against ground types. We'll see fire, really. Let's see. Yeah, we have 4 fire types, and then we have 2 poison types. Alright, not a bad lineup here. We can totally do this. Let's send out the Nidoking, and then Sandslash, and then, let's see what we're gonna do. Is that we're gonna throw an Alakazam for backup, say, because they're poison type Pokemon, right? Right? Am I right? 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 Am I right? 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 Okay, let's do this. See, he's such a monster of a Pokemon, but he's like, ugh, I hate that freaking. I so hate that he's like that small. Look at that, he's almost Charmeleon's height. Take it down on the word go. I never get tired of that. I seriously won't. Who does? Who gets tired of this in order for them to like turn off the voice actor? It's a weird looking ponytail, by the way. You probably already noticed by now, but like, some of these other Pokemon that are on the other side, you probably would consider them shinies, but no, if you actually look at the actual shiny version of Ponyta, it looks almost nothing like this. So, yeah. It's a one-hit wonder.
There's a difference in the number of reserved
Pokemon. Some of these nicknames are just weird, like Pota? Poto, really? Okay, I don't even know how to pronounce that. It's like Niran? 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 Anyway, I think Nidoran is just poison, so this should do the trick. Yep, it did. It totally did. And you are out of here. And there goes the battle. Take that, pre-evolution of myself. TKO. Screw you, old man. I'll walk on your front lawn any day of the week, sir. Alright, I'm surprised he doesn't have Electabuzz. Because I know in the anime he was making fun of Ash for his baby Pikachu, and then he brought out his Raichu. Again, why doesn't he have like Electabuzz here? That totally boggles my mind almost. Anyway, all these Pokemon are weak against ground, so yeah, Marowak, Neo King, and Sandslash. Are we good with this? Are we good, man? Are we good, bro? Yeah, let's do it. Yeah! Kick Sarge's ass!
Here he is! Lieutenant Surge, the leader of Vermilion. Vermilion Gym and the commander of Electric Pokemon.
In the main game, she talks about how he used his electric Pokemon in war. What kind of war did you use electric Pokemon with? What the heck? What? Dude! Okay. I am both impressed by that and, like, sort of terrified by that. Okay, I only thought that if you used your Pokemon Yellow Pikachu, then it would surf like that. I didn't know that Surge had a surfing Pikachu. What? Oh my lord. What? That's the first time I ever saw that, really. What? I'm sorry, I'm just totally... Oh, this one knows surf too? Wait, was it surf? Oh my... I don't even know if it was surfing on a surfboard. Oh my god, I might actually lose here. Ah. Alright. Sand Slash, you're probably a bit faster. What? Why do these Pokemon know surf? Okay, at least I have Dig. Come on, you gotta at least give me this. Oh, no! No, live, please live. Please, take a hit. Take a good hit. Sand Slash, come on, no. Oh, thank you. Okay, am I actually, like, pull through this? That took me by surprise. I haven't played this in a while. I had no idea that some of these Pokemon knew surf.
What's this?
Oh.
It's the target.
Oh, my. Oh.
It's
oh, please die. Please die. I don't have to do. Yes. Oh. Oh, that would have been bad. That would have been really bad. That would have been like.
Ugh.
I didn't practice. Some Let's Players out there actually do, like, test practice, like, their games before they do a Let's Play on them. I don't. I didn't. Oh, no, he's gonna take me out right here. Who do I have? Neo King, okay. Alright. Neo King, you could probably take a good Hyper Beam, right? Yeah, it looks like it gets dish out some damage.
Just one
or dish out, or it takes some damage. Takes some good damage. Alright, come on. Come on, one hit, come on. Let's do it. Yes. No whammies. Oh! Oh, I was gonna say, didn't really know Dig or something? I'm probably gonna regret this. I'm just gonna use Poison Sting again. Oh, what? Oh, what do you have? Oh. Oh, no. Oh. Oh, my lord. I'm taking a couple of different risks here and there. You know, I talk about how Ash is sort of a novice Pokemon trainer. Even I make mistakes even here and there. Like that. This Let's Play episode has just been me, like, making mistakes with Neo King. I know I should be spamming Earthquake, but sometimes Earthquake isn't as accurate as I hope it would be. Because there is a possibility that Earthquake does miss. So it sort of works like Thunder in that aspect. Where it's not that accurate, but it is the most powerful ground-type move. So yeah. A bit of another close one, because we are coming up to the point where it is going to get very progressively harder. So, that about does it for Lieutenant Surge. Next episode, we're going to be taking on the Celadon City Gym, and that has Erica at the helm here. And, yeah, we're going to see you guys in the next Let's Play, where we are going to toast her Pokemon.